What fascinates me about virtual reality is the ability to actually put you in a totally different place, in a totally different world. And you can walk inside of that world and you can look all around, you can look up, down, the same way that you would look in the physical world, but you are inside the content. That's what virtual reality does. Today, we have very powerful mobile phones that are capable of rendering virtual reality technologies.
So this is a technology that has really come of age recently, and Mary, through her company Seek, is right on the cutting edge.
Wherever she's put her hand in and pointed her vision, just you've seen phenomenal results. It's almost as if she was destined or born to do this.
So my career, a lot of times people say, well, how do you go from being a deep space engineer, you know, launching rockets into space, to now you're working on virtual reality and entertainment and all of that. But it's really, my career is just one big evolution, and it's evolved with how media has evolved. I guess wherever I go, it's basically where media is going. I just stay ahead of it.
Seek is so innovative, and that is because Mary is so innovative. Being on her own with a smaller company enables her to develop one technology after the other. They are all patented, they are all innovative, and they are all marketable.
What I'm doing now is Seek VR. We're able to partner with all these companies. Well, Tribune News Company has used our technology, Coca-Cola Company, Xbox, MS Communications, Gatorade, and Universal Music with over 32 labels. Oh, Apple. So this year we won the Clio for our VR experience that we created with Megadeth for Universal Music. When there's no more grace,
does your heart... What you think of when you think of Mary Spio, you know, someone that really cares, has passion, but more importantly, wants positive change, and change for all.
I was born in Syracuse, but I grew up in Ghana because my father, my parents are from Ghana. I was about 8 years or so when the government was overtaken by military rogues. So I escaped through television. It was our magic box. It was our place where we could escape. I saw stuff on space exploration, people walking on the moon. It was also where I began to wonder what it would feel like to be inside of the television.
Mary Spio, take a look at how her childhood hobby turned out to be her true calling in life.
I dreamed of coming to America as the place where anything was possible. I had a moment of insight. I thought to myself, everything that I was seeing had been created by someone. So could it be possible that all of life is simply what we imagine it to be? So I set out to create my own imagination. After I graduated from high school, I decided to join the Air Force. I was a satellite communications technician. I was in Desert Storm, and I was encouraged to apply for a scholarship for all of the US Air Forces in Europe. And that year I scored the highest, so I was a recipient of the scholarship for Outstanding Airmen. And I went to Syracuse. It was actually the only school I applied to. I knew that if I, you know, ever came back to the US, I would go back to Syracuse because that's where I was born while my dad was a student. And, you know, I always say I received my Jedi powers with my degree because I could not believe the amount of opportunities that were available to me. The Boeing company came calling to come up with a technology for distributing movies of a satellite. I was one of three engineers that Boeing hired. We came up with the entire design and rolled it out to 30,000 theaters. The digital cinema technology, you see the three of the ground floor patents. I'm listed as a sole inventor. Star Wars Episode II was the first movie that we distributed over Boeing Digital Cinema. Education is going to be the biggest contribution that VR makes because humans are visual learners. We're also working with a lot of different schools and medical facilities developing curriculum for them to deliver content.
The jewelry experience is one very emotionally driven. Ridgeline, as part of the Berkshire Hathaway Corporation, one of our major projects should be what we call the Future Store. And Mary both creatively showed us a direction that we should be pursuing, the items that we should be concentrating on. Whatever we had thought of, she doubled our thinking.
Mary is very unique. She's so humble and unassuming. You don't look at her and go, I'm talking to someone who's incredibly brilliant.
I'm fortunate to have the opportunity to share my story around the world. through my book, It's Not Rocket Science, and then also at working with the U.S. Department of State to be an ambassador of innovation and entrepreneurship. And I do that because I want to be able to encourage people to think much bigger.
I believe that my life is a simple example of some of the possibilities that we're able to access with technology.
If Boeing hadn't given me the opportunity, digital cinema created an entire industry just from this African child. You know, when you look at my pictures from growing up, I looked no different than the kids that you see in the UNICEF commercial. And so when I see the same kids and the same people that everybody walks past, I don't walk past those people. I don't look past those people because those the people, that's me.
Yesterday we had Steve Jobs, today we have Mark Zuckerberg, tomorrow we have Mary Spio, and that's the way history shall remember it.
The final words that my dad said to me as I left my journey for America when I was 16, and he said to me, "My daughter, my dream for you is to always see our world with that sense of wonder, and my hope for you is that you'll make magic wherever you point your focus."